Before we get into today's tutorial, I want to let you guys know that there's only a couple more days before our deadline for the Halloween contest. The deadline is the 24th of October. If this is the first time that you're hearing about it, don't be alarmed. You can still enter, you can still send everything in. There is a link in this card up here that you can go and follow, and it will tell you everything that you need to know. You can even sign up in the link in the description. So go check it out and get involved, because there is over $10,000 worth of prizes to give away. Hello and welcome to another HitFilm tutorial. I'm Tom, and today we're going to be learning about digital makeup, specifically the zombies. In recent years, zombies have become a huge staple of the horror genre, and because of their design, you can do these on a low budget. But if you don't have makeup or effects or any specialism with that, we have a free way for you to do a zombie effect. This tutorial can be completely followed in HitFilm Express, but I'm going to be working in Pro and mentioning a couple of plugins that you can use to ease your workflow. Let's get into it. You'll notice that we applied tracking markers to the face area. This is because the eyes move separately and we'll be applying different effects to the eyes. So these are the dots that we'll be tracking and applying effects onto. So entering the dropdown and hitting the plus icon, this will open up the tracker window. Now before we track, we're gonna make sure that the type is set to double point and then placing the markers over the areas that we want. Then punch it, track it. It's important to note that we kept our actor, Ollie, facing towards the camera. Because of this tracking method, it's not going to capture the 3D turnarounds. If you're interested in doing a more 3D rotation and movement, I highly recommend checking out our tutorial on the zombie clickers from The Last of Us, or if you're a Blender user, checking out our cyborg tracking tutorial. Once we have this completely tracked and we're happy with the data, we then need a layer to attach this onto. A point layer is definitely the preferred. Head to the new layer icon and create a point. We can name this face track. Be sure to enable scale and rotation before hitting apply. Because zombies don't have tracking markers on their face, we're going to need to remove them. Find a clear frame of your actor and take a still frame, being sure to re-import it back into the timeline. Mask an area close to the marker, feather it, and reposition it over the tracking point. Now you can parent this to our point layer. Depending on how many tracking markers you actually use, you may need to repeat this several times using different tracks. Now that the tracking is done and the face is clean, let's move on to some effects. Create a new plane and name it veins. Mask an area around the face and feather. In the generate folder, we're going to find and apply fractal noise. Change the type to energy. And under transform, we're going to decrease the scale, just until we got something that looks very veiny. Once you have a size you like, go into color correction and apply curves, being sure to lower the shadows and increase the highlights. We want to make sure that there is nothing but black and white. Now that we have the tone that we want, let's apply a tint. Increase the amount to 100% and set the white to an off skin tone. Or if you're feeling creative, go for a green or blue. But we're now starting to get the main design. Apply a demult from keying, and this will eliminate all the black areas. After your demult, apply a matte cleaner if you want to feather the edges or soften those details. Now we can apply an invert to reveal that detail again. Lastly, setting the blend mode to soft light. Don't forget to parent this layer to our face track. He's now looking infected. We want to make him look grubby. Duplicate this layer and rename it to dirt. Heading into your fractal noise, scale this up so it creates larger patches. Let's move the tint down so it's underneath the invert. Reset it using Ctrl and R or right clicking, and change the blacks to a dark red. Finally, lowering the opacity to about 50%. What's great about this effect is that it's not exclusive to just the face area. You can even use this for bites, which I'm sure this is fine. It's fine. So far so good, but we're not looking undead. In the project file, we have provided a PNG of a skull. Import this into the composite shot, and lower the opacity, just so we can see what we're doing. Using position, scale, and rotation, move this into place so it's over your actor's face. All we're going to do now is mask the areas that we want to keep. I'm going to keep the nose and cheekbones, then increasing the feather to help the blend. We can now turn up the opacity and that's a little bit saturated. And don't forget to parent the skull to our face track. Currently, it stands out far too much, so we're going to be using the levels histogram to help blend. What the levels effect does is very similar to the curves. You can control the shadows, highlights, and also the separate RGB colors. By playing around with the gamma and black and white levels, you can adjust the skull so it fits better with your actor. I personally find it easier to blend a black and white image. You can do this by going into the Options tab and down to Color Channels, then selecting which channel that you want to enter, red, green, and blue. What this is doing is giving you a clean slate, so all you have to focus on is blending a black and white image. You need to make sure that the tones are similar to the surrounding area. This may take some time, so do play around with the different levels as your scene may be very different to mine. Once you're feeling confident, head back into the color channels and go back to RGB. We're looking better, but if you go and apply a hue and saturation effect and dial down the saturation by about 20, this should help it stand out less. Another thing to help compositing is to apply a small blur effect, just something very subtle that can blend with your camera's softness. Now that we have this skeletal structure, let's make some shadows. Create a new plane layer named Shadows. Mask the two eye areas, being sure to give it enough feather to blend in. This time around, we're going to mask each eye, going to the controls panel and setting these two masks to subtract. Now set the blend mode to soft light and dial the opacity down to 50%. He's still looking rather tanned right now, so one last thing that we can do is go to the new layer icon and create a grade layer. We can name this Pale. Once more, mask the area that we want, parent this to our face track, and all we're going to do is apply a hue, saturation, and lightness, and just dial down the saturation. From here, you can apply any effect that you want. Scars, burns, eye effects. The final result is the Dawn of the Dead. And if you're wondering how to do those zombie eyes, I highly recommend you checking out our Fantasy Eyes tutorial. Javert breaks down how to do everything from demons to witches, fantasy warlocks, and more. It's a great tutorial and one I would recommend to enhance this zombie makeup. So go check it out. And that is how you can create a digital undead. I really do hope that you've enjoyed this tutorial and it's been of use to you. We would love to see anything that you guys are working on our Discord. We have finally set up a Discord and we couldn't be happier with it. It's a perfect place to share your work with the community, get feedback, and get involved with other creatives. We have loved seeing everyone's work up to press, so head on over, share yours, and get involved. If you found this tutorial helpful, please do give us a like. It really helps us out. And if you're new, consider subscribing. We do weekly tutorials for you, so if there is anything that you want to know, leave us a comment. We'll see to it. And I will see you in the next tutorial.